Okay, so at least you know whose car this is.
Yeah, it's an old Durant that it, he eventually made into a pickup, cut the back off of it off and made a pickup out of it so he could use it in the orchard.
So that's Charlie Poe and his wife?
I think it's Mamie.
Yeah.
Mamie. And then who else is in that picture? There's four people.
I don't know.
I think on the back of the picture it said it was friends, some friend and his daughter.
Okay.
And that's Uncle Howard and his dog, and they were out across the street from Dunlap Acres where Charlie Poe lived at that time. And
is that in Redlands or Ukiper?
In Dunlap Acres.
That's the city.
Well, it's in between Redlands and Ukiper.
I never
it's
heard
about
of it.
Where the high school is now. And that's a picture of us in front of his house on 2nd Street in Ukiper.
And Grandpa. Who's this down here?
That's me and Gene and Shirley.
So how old were you in that picture?
Probably about 8 or 9. And that I thought was Grandpa Poe.
That is.
When he was young.
Yep. So that's Charlie Poe, and I think the thing, didn't the thing say he was like 16 years old or something like that? The back of the picture?
That was Howard.
Howard as a baby. And Howard was Grandpa's brother.
Right.
Half-brother.
Half-brother that was about, what, how many years younger? About 4?
Uncle Howard?
Yeah, about 4 years younger than...
Yeah.
More than that, I think.
He didn't look at all like a cop in this picture.
No.
Doesn't have a motorcycle anyway. Yeah, there's Mamie and...
Charlie and Mamie?
Charlie and Mamie, look like.
No. On the back of the picture it said Jesse.
That's Jesse.
Yeah.
That's second wife.
Yes. That's Howard's
mom. I can't see that thing.
Well, you guys can't see, you can't hear, you can't talk. But I'm
right.
In good shape. I know who that is.
Would that be Don and Darryl?
Don and Darryl. Do you remember that picture? Do you remember when that picture was taken?
No, it was probably
it
up
be in...
It
would be in 1952 sometime.
Probably up up in...
The Air Force Base.
Moffett Field somewhere.
So you were in the service then?
Yeah.
Looks like... Did you have a pencil-thin mustache type thing then?
Yeah, I had a mustache.
Have you had one your whole life?
Not all the time, but most of the time.
Kid.
Charlie Poe and Pappy Poe and
Jesse.
Probably Howard and Jesse.
And Grandpa had a lot of hair then.
Yeah, look at that.
Well,
that's
he only
amazing.
Kept it until he was 21 or 22, and then he lost it. That's
that one, maybe.
Grandma and Grandpa Poe.
Yeah. Can you tell where it's at?
No.
What's in the background?
That's the church in Mountain View where we got married.
So you and Kitty, and you guys had to get married with somebody else or just friends?
Bill Reedy was the best man, and Gloria Pomelo was the...
Right.
Maid of honor or whatever. You
best woman.
Okay.
So what year was this?
1950, I think, yeah.
No kids then?
Not yet.
No.
Well, you know, sometimes you had to get married, you know? I mean,
yeah.
That's a great picture of Grandma and Grandpa.
Dad, Mom,
Grandma.
They're shitty Chevrolet.
In the driveway on Orange Street.
Orange Street. 1007 Orange.
You guys remember that well, don't you? Because you guys were...
It was 1007?
We were there a long time. 1007 Orange.
My address here is 1006.
I knew that.
Oh.
That's why you couldn't find it.
Yeah.
And the house right behind me on the other side of the alley was where Grandma
I don't know.
Schnitter
was that Shirley? Or?
Was
I think that's Shirley. Dad, is that Shirley and you?
Yep.
Yes.
Shirley, me. I was right about then going down to Los Alamitos.
So is that...
We took some pictures.
That's Grandma and Grandpa then.
Just getting ready to report for duty.
That was like the only time you guys took a bunch of pictures, wasn't it?
Just about.
Oh, for some reason we all got pictures of
Uncle Jack and me.
So you were telling me about Uncle Jack's history. He was a cook.
He was a chef and a truck driver and
jack of all trades.
Yeah, jack of all. So what was the restaurant you said that they worked in?
Wissahickon Inn.
Well, that's what Gene said. He worked at the Wissahickon Inn for a while, I guess.
So, Dad, what were you doing right then, just before you reported to service?
What was I doing?
Yeah.
Well, I was getting ready to get in my little 34 Ford coupe and head for Los Alamitos.
Where were you working, though, before then?
Who knows? I was going on active duty there. Probably a service station or something. I'm highly trained.
That's Shirley and Gene and...
No, it's not Shirley.
That's Carol.
That's Carol.
Carol and...
Uncle Laverne.
And Charlotte.
Carol and me. Me. And there's sort of the basement where we got to live, Donald.
That's where Donald lived?
Yeah.
Donald and me.
Now this, we're starting to get into some more recent history stuff. Now this is with Donald and Kitty, and you got like three kids there.
Must have been
start from the top.
Me.
Daryl and Donna and Mike, probably.
Yeah, that's who it is.
Michael's a little squirt.
Mm-hmm.
This is a little hard to see, but that's like a typical family reunion for the Poe family, isn't it?
That looks like Grandpa Poe's bald head.
Sure
it
does.
Yeah, it is.
It's hard to
see.
That's Grandpa Charlie here.
That's Grandpa Charlie. Right. He always wore spenders.
But Grandpa's back there in the corner.
No, that's what I meant. Grandpa Charlie Poe.
Yeah.
And Aunt,
your grandpa's different
Aunt
than
Rose.
Mine.
Aunt Rose is right there.
Yeah, that was Grandpa Charlie.
How often did you guys get together?
We used to get together quite a bit in the old days. They used to come over just about every Sunday for dinner.
A lot of fun.
You have a big dinner like that every Sunday with all of you?
We usually have Aunt Bertie, Uncle Jack, and sometimes Laverne, Charlotte.
Yeah.
Whose house?
Most of the time was it on Orange Street at our house. But Dad only was available every other Sunday. So. And usually Mom would fix fried chicken or something for Sunday dinner.
I don't think that's Orange Street house there. But.
Okay, Donna, you know the history of this one.
All I know is it snowed that day, and that's at Grandma and Grandpa's house when they lived in Yucaipa.
Mm-hmm.
We made that nice snowman, and Debbie jumped on it and messed it all up. She made everybody mad at her that day.
Mm-hmm. Okay. This looks like a Christmas thing or something.
I can't see their faces well enough.
Well, there's Grandpa up there.
Mike's on his lap. Mom, and that's Jerry next to her. And then that's Willie.
Where's Willie?
Right there.
Right there
that's
in the back
Willie.
Corner.
Uh-huh. And then that's Debbie and Danny next to her in the cowboy hat. And Daryl and myself.
Hmm. So where would you have been living then? The parquet floor, is this your house or is this Grandma and Grandpa's house?
Well, it might have been there on San Jacinto.
Yeah. If it was our house, it was San Jacinto, but I don't know.
That was just San Jacinto. That would have been our house, and that
and
would have also
Shirley's
been Shirley's house.
House. Too. Yeah.
Everybody in the family lived there.
That's Karen and Mom and Dad. That's on Eureka Street in the late 50s. There's Grandma and Karen, and then that's their car.
Was Grandma working then?
Well, she used to work at the hospitals.
In the laundry out
in
there.
In the laundry out there for several years, but I don't know if she was.
But that was a long time ago. Wasn't it?
Yeah. Well, she didn't have. I don't think she had kids at home. If she did, we were all older.
Yeah.
That's out at the Horse Ranch in San Timoteo Canyon.
You said you were doing the posse.
Redlands Mounted Police at that time. I was the coordinator for it. The guy that owned that ranch out there let me use one of his horses to ride in parades and I think this particular one, we were having a rodeo for raising money for the...
So you spend a lot of time riding horses?
No.
I was going to say, you look pretty good.
Set up straight for the picture.
Yep. That looks like...
Looks like Aunt Annie in the middle.
Yep. Annie, and then that would be Zelda.
Shirley.
And Shirley.
And Debbie.
No.
Yes.
Down no, below, down Debbie lower.
Down. Oh, down below. Yeah, I don't even see down here. How about that? So you guys can see the feet, but you can't see her head. She's a black hole. This looks like when you were a teenager cooking.
No.
No? Already married, away in the service? Yeah?
Probably in the housing in South San Francisco.
Cracker box things.
Well, they had a very large stove. I can see that much. You could cook a turkey.
There was a bathroom, a living room, and a bedroom, and that was about it. No.
That's a nice picture.
That's another picture of Grandma and Grandpa Poe.
And Grandma and
no,
Grandpa
wait.
Poe.
And great grandpa.
Yeah.
Grandma.
So
no, it doesn't look like it. It looks. I don't know.
This looks like Charlie over here, isn't it?
Yeah, that does.
Charlie,
that looks like Grandma.
That's Grandma. And
that
that's
like
Charlie's
Mamie.
Wife. It's it's not Mamie. It's his last wife.
Last
but
wife.
We don't know what her name is.
And then me.
And then you.
Or not me,
and
but
Grandpa.
Grandpa Cole.
Yeah.
Pappy.
Pappy. P-hole.
Yep.
I don't know who that is.
That's Daryl and Grandpa and the dog. And I don't know if that's Grandpa's dog or if it's Uncle Jack's.
It's Uncle Jack's backyard.
Yeah, Daryl said he used to always go to Uncle Jack's and play with the dog.
Yeah, it's Uncle Jack's backyard.
I remember Uncle Jack falling out of the tree when he was harvesting walnuts and breaking...
Broken bones, yeah.
Yeah.
And he was like 70 years old when he did that.
Oh, not good.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is that Uncle Jack again?
That's Grandpa.
That's Grandpa and me.
Grandpa Hurley.
And Debbie.
And Debbie, yeah.
This one's you on the left, right?
Uh-huh. That's Mom.
That's your mom, and there's the angel above her, right?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
And Daryl and me. And I'm thinking either me or Mike.
Well, if that's Daryl, that's pretty well got to be you, doesn't it? I mean,
I would think, yeah. If he's not more than two there.
He's running around in shorts, so he's...
Still running around in shorts today. What are you talking about?
That's Shirley. And
no, that's me and you.
That's what I meant to say Donna.
Shirley,
I said
Donna.
Shirley.
They all run together after a while.
That was Long Beach.
Is that in Long Beach?
Yeah.
So can you still get down like that on your legs?
Yeah, I can get down, but I can't get back up.
All right, so
there's,
which wife is this?
That's the last one.
Wife number three.
Or four.
No, four? They said he had four or five.
Four?
Yeah, at least four. So this is not
five?
Too long before he passed away then.
Wow.
No, not too long.
Not too long. So is this in their house?
Probably a new Kuiper.
There's a family reunion. This is back a few years ago, because...
That's Gene.
Yeah, got my dad
Gene
there.
Ann.
Is that at the Rusty Lantern?
No,
no,
this is a house.
That was at either Grandma's house, or... Looks around, actually around the same table.
Who had chairs that had little rivets going around the back end? And the checkered tablecloth.
It must have been someplace else. I don't remember what house.
This looks like a birthday party in the Poe house.
That's
on San Jacinto. We used to
in
have
the
that.
So who's wearing the hat?
Daniel.
Looks like Danny.
Danny's wearing a hat. And then that would be, what? Is that? Who's next to him?
Looks
Mike?
Looks like Mike.
Mike.
Daryl.
Daryl in the back.
Debbie.
And this is you kind of, this must be your birthday.
It
looks
it
like
was
you're
my birthday. I look pretty
How
excited,
about
don't
that?
I?
Yeah.
I was five.
Cool. Can't count the candles on that cake. And this is Mike in a baseball outfit there?
Yeah, that's a Little League deal.
That's on Eureka Street in the backyard.
Well, I spent a lot of time at that house.
Yep. Used to walk on that wall.
Used to walk on that wall, on that roof, everywhere. You name it. There wasn't a part of that
can't
house.
Can't even
we
see who's
on.
In that picture.
This is the bait shop.
Howard
Poe. Yeah.
He's wearing his captain hat, so it's I'm Howard.
Is he sitting down?
No.
And that's in the driveway on Orange Street again.
Look how long your pants were.
Well, you used to buy Levi's that way, and then you could turn them up on the bottom.
So what
that
did
was
you do?
The fashion.
The extra stuff. You just left it there?
Yeah, you just leave it there.
Whenever I did that, I always got those filled up with dirt. Grandma was pretty good looking there, wasn't she? She didn't.
That's when she was working at the hospital.
Because he looks like she has a white outfit on. Too bad we don't have that car anymore, huh?
47 Chevy, 46 Chevy.
46. The black one?
There's Donna in her suit that you tried to burn up.
Who tried to burn it up?
I did.
You did?
I guess mom she got came it. Home and I was hungry. I wanted her to cook and we were bringing the groceries in. So I couldn't wait. I got up on a chair and turned on the stove and that how that dress
yeah, that
goes out and it caught on fire. Mom walked in with the bag of groceries and she said I had a ring of fire all the way around me.
And you were just kind of like waiting or what?
Yeah, standing there I guess.
That was before, before they did the drop and roll thing?
Yeah.
And who's next to you?
Daryl.
Well, look at that stud.
Yeah.
Yep, so I think that's Dad, isn't it?
Yep.
That's Gene.
Yep. And he's got his hands on his hips like...
He's cool.
I'm cool. Gotta have a pack of cigarettes in there somewhere, I'm sure.
Up in his sleeve.
Rolled up in his sleeve. I think this is a great picture. This is where your dad is standing on the bumper. And he's got you two guys standing in front of him.
What's
the
kind of car? The black one?
It's that same one.
No,
yeah.
That's the Chevy. Yeah.
46 Chevy, 46.
You're in uniform and I'm in my Levi's and t-shirt. You're taken at the same time as that other picture, it looks like.
Yeah.
So were you already out of the service at this point when Gene was going in?
Or yeah, I probably was.
Well, there wasn't.
I went in 1950. That's about when you were getting out. Didn't you go in 46?
I got out in 51.
Okay, so a little overlap.
Well, I saw one picture you guys both had uniforms on together.
They did?
Yeah, one picture.
I don't remember seeing that.
This must be a duplicate.
That's me on my 9th or 10th birthday on Colton Avenue. And
I can't believe you wore white pants.
Yeah, I wore whatever they gave me to wear.
He wasn't near as sloppy as I was.
Yeah, if Dad wore white pants nowadays, that would be so funny.
Well, even in those days, that would have been a disaster.
Well, that was the front yard where I gave Gene a ride on my feet and he broke his arm.
Right on the sidewalk.
Hey, didn't you break your arm in a washing machine once, too?
Well, yeah, he stuck his arm in a wringer.
What did you think was going to happen?
The ringer ate me up.
What did you think was going to happen when you stuck your arm
in
the ringer?
At 3 or 4 years old, I don't think I cared.
And then I slammed the car door on his finger.
Yeah, taking him to the plunge.
Oh, here it is, the picture with both of them in uniform.
Both of you in uniform right there.
And is that Carol between you again?
Bring it up closer, let me see.
Oh, yeah, right.
It looks like the blonde, not Shirley.
Somebody with a kind of gold.
Like
it's Carol.
Carol, okay, and curly hair.
Yeah, that's Gene and me.
Yep.
I must have been home on leave or something because I got semen stripes on.
How far did you go? Did you just go to semen?
Second class.
Did you go to second class?
Yeah.
You're aviation?
No, electronics technician.
So what year did you go in and when did you come out?
Went in 48 and come out in 52.
So where did you spend most of your time in the service?
Moffett Field.
Stayed there?
Oakland.
Near Mountain View. And
didn't do too much overseas or anything like that?
No, I joined the Navy, went to boot camp in California. Went to Moffett Field in San Francisco.
So you got to see the Sea World, and that was about it.
Yeah.
Disneyland and Sea World.
From New York to California.
Look at her.
That's Dana and Karen.
No, it's
no, Donna. Donna and Jerry.
No, it isn't. That's Dana and
is
Karen.
Is it Dana? Okay, Dana and Karen.
Probably one of the few pictures of them together, not killing each other.
Yep.
Look to me more like Donna and Jerry.
It does look like Donna and Jerry, doesn't it?
That's Dana and Karen. That's on Eureka Street.
Yeah, it is on Eureka Street.
Well, I was 7 years old when we moved to Eureka Street.
Well, it could be either pair, couldn't it?
It could, because Dana looks a lot like me,
yeah,
even
with her hair,
now
yeah.
She does. And Karen probably resembles Jerry more as a baby. But that's definitely Karen and Dana.
And that's that house in Lancaster.
Yeah, now the picture said Zelda and Donald.
Well, we could have been. We were out there visiting Aunt Bertie and Uncle Jack.
Now, this isn't Bertie and Jack's house.
Yeah.
It is? We always had the pictures of...
Well, that's not their house. That's in Lancaster.
That's in Lancaster.
This is not their one in San Bernardino.
Not the one in San Bernardino or the one in Banning, because they lived in a similar to that one, kind of like a motel for a while in Banning.
We had a picture like of Clementine sitting in that chair, right? Was it Clementine or was it...
Grandma Snitter.
Snitter, sitting in that chair.
Grandma Snitter in there.
Okay, well, so that's why I thought maybe that was Grandma Snitter's place.
Well, she could have gone out with us. I don't know.
I don't remember hardly anything of that.
That was a long way to the old days.
Yeah.
There's Daryl and Mike.
Daryl and Mike. Donna.
And Donna, I think.
Jerry.
And Jerry Ann. And there's a dog in there, isn't there?
Yeah. That doesn't look like Princess. I can't remember that dog's name. Dad made that patio cover.
You were a carpenter too?
We put...
It's that lattice stuff.
That aluminum stripes and wove it on the top. Of Didn't keep the rain out. But.
I like that one of Bertie and Jack. Isn't that a good picture of them?
Yeah.
I have
the... That's Willie in the background.
Willie in the background. Yeah. I have a picture of Bertie and Jack where Jack was coming up behind her and grabbing her boobs.
Oh, yeah.
Behind her.
He probably did that a lot.
And well, I mean, you know, because Bertie, you know, she's always very expressive, but, you know, mm-hmm. She had her mouth just like, screaming.
Sylvan Park. Used to have all the
See, I went to their house quite a bit when I was around, but I don't know that any of my brothers remember going there.
Yeah.
Because I went there once in a while when I was older, too. I went there on my own a couple of times, I think. I hear Daryl in the background.
Yeah. We're going to hear Daryl.
All right, here you all are. This is all the kids. And
all the kids of what?
Your kids. You probably can't even recognize
them. At the park. That's Grandma. Kitty.
Kitty.
And Karen. And, yeah, Dana.
Dana. Jerry next to your mom.
Mike
in the back. There's you.
With my mouth open.
Daryl. I put that in there because you said you liked that picture, right?
No, especially I didn't like that picture.
Oh, okay. Maybe it was this
that
picture you
liked. That picture I said was much better.
Oh, okay. Yeah, this one looks more like you all still look now, except for Daryl's hair is a little shorter.
Yeah, shaved.
He didn't have the investment in tattoos back then either.
No.
Yeah. And so I wonder what year this was. Oh, there it is. It says right in there. It says like 91.
There you go.
12/21. So this was your Christmas get together.
Yeah, that was it.
In
when Dana was living at
1991
in a trailer park, so we used the clubhouse.
Good idea.
Mm-hmm. It was.
Now you said that this has some story behind this.
Only that's where we used to go on vacation every single year. The Oceanside.
We'd rent a cabin or something for a week if we could afford it, or 2 weeks.
Did you guys go to the Whitmer's? What was the place we stayed at?
No, Uncle Jack and Aunt Bertie used to go there more.
Winton?
Yeah. We never stayed there.
Because you guys had a trailer then for a long time too, didn't you?
We had a trailer in Oceanside for a while, yeah.
So is that Daryl there?
Yep.
Daryl? Yeah. And who's sitting in the chair?
Dad.
Okay.
And Karen. And Mike.
Mike over there.
Away.
Good picture.
That's Daryl today, what he does every year for every. His vacation.
Now this is how I remember you all the time, Donald.
Wearing a hat.
Well, wearing a hat and sunglasses and out cavatting around. What do you got there? Picnicking?
Yeah, that was his birthday party.
Oh, birthday party.
At Sylvan Park.
Where else?
I think that's Jennifer when she's little.
It does look like Jennifer, doesn't it? So this would be one of Mike's kids, perhaps.
I can't see. It's probably Emily or Emily. Sarah. That yeah. looks like Sarah.
No, Emily's married and going to have a child. Okay, we threw a couple again. Pictures in here of all the families together. So tell me about this family. Mike?
Well, that's Mike and Emily and...
Sarah and Kathy.
No, Kathy and Emily and Sarah, I guess.
That's who they look like. The Smiths.
Dan and Jerry and Brian.
Mm-hmm. A while back.
Uh-oh. There's
Where
a half a scan. Doggone it.
You messed up the scan. That was a good picture.
A terrible one. Oh, wait.
Mike's
I've
good.
Redeemed myself.
Oh, there
Look at
you
that.
Go.
There's the old 55 Merc.
That was a
beautiful car. First one we took back east.
Is that the one you had all the flat tires on?
No.
That was the Poe Mobile. Yeah.
that we only, I think Dana was the baby at the time.
Yeah, so that's only Daryl and me and Mike and Jerry with Grandma and Grandpa.
And it's in front of what house?
Well, somebody's leg is sticking out.
Yeah, that's Daryl.
That's Daryl?
It's Daryl.
What are you doing?
Oh, Mike's on the other side.
Yeah, that's Mike. I think that was at the Yucaipa house when they lived in Yucaipa.
Yeah, probably.
Believe it or not, this is the very last picture.
All that's 51. The one where we were messing around during the Surrey days.
Is that State Street in Redlands?
It's the corner of State and Orange.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. This is the La Posada Hotel. Before they tore it down.
Well, you look pretty tough to me. You know, I wouldn't want to mess with you.